you look around in the world today, you can see a very destructive story. A story of obsessive consumerism that is destroying the planet, of materialism gone wild that is completely unsustainable, that is destroying the fabric, the very subtle, beautifully woven ecosystem that supports us. And the great unspoken tragedy of this present time is how this story is destroying the sacred both within the world and also within people's souls. It is a very soulless story. It's like consumerism takes our money and also takes our life energy and takes our soul. As we are programmed to want more and more and more in a completely unsustainable way. Of course, many people recognize this destructive story of greed. What is really unknown is why this story is so powerful. There is a very powerful energy, a very powerful magic in this selling of stuff. Because we are entranced by materialism. Anybody logically knows that it's not going to fulfill you, it's not going to make your life happy. And yet, the entrancement is so powerful that we are caught. The magic is so strong, particularly because it is unrecognized. We don't believe in magic as a culture, we believe in the rational world, and yet what we are doing is completely irrational. We don't believe in the inner worlds, and yet we are gripped by the inner worlds. But there are many people who are talking about the need for a new story. But if it is lacking an understanding of the magical pull of the old story, nothing will happen. You can't counter that powerful and magical pull with rationalism, because you can see now, it doesn't work. As a culture, we have said the inner world doesn't exist, magic doesn't exist, and yet human beings for thousands of years have known about spells. Why are those first beautiful cave paintings in southern France of the animals in their archetypal form? Because it was a magical relationship that the hunter was creating with what he was hunting. There was a prayer there, there was a magical relationship. So that's the present predicament. Now there is a new story, yes. It's a new story, it's also a very old story. It is a very different story to that of consumption and greed and dominance of nature. It's a story of interdependence, of interconnectivity. It's a story of oneness in which there is this incredible diversity of creation, of human beings, of animals, of plants, of birds, that are all part of a great unified living being we call the earth. We are not separate from the earth. We are not separate from each other. We are all an interwoven pattern of unity that breathes the same breath on a very deep level. If this is a moment of crisis, it's also a moment to welcome in a very different story, a story of cooperation rather than competition. Oneness is not an idea. It's a living reality, it's a living presence. It has to do with the nature of life, the nature of creation. There are patterns. This is actually an esoteric understanding that you can see in Islamic design, these interwoven patterns. And sacred geometry represents these patterns behind creation. They're actually very powerful. They show the way the world is woven together, how it comes together as certain nodes that have, like stars, that have more energy, and then separates. And you can see that also when, you know, groups of people come together, they form energy nodes, and then they link to other groups. It's a very organic way of being. Thomas Berry was one of the first people to write about the importance of a new story. And he said, "My effort here is to articulate the outlines of a new mythic form that would evoke a creative entrancement to succeed the destructive entrancement that has taken possession of the Western soul in recent centuries. We can counter one entrancement only with another, a counter-entrancement. We are talking here about the inner world as much as the outer world. In all of the dialogue about this new story, to me there is this fundamental aspect lacking, which has to do with the inner world and the power that comes from the inner world and the change that comes from the inner world. Because in order to make a shift, you need power, you need energy. Like Thomas Berry says, it needs a certain psychic energy in order to rebirth life. So there is a new story that is waiting to be born, but it has to include this magical, archetypal dimension, this energy from the inner world. The next story is not going to be just a human story. And it's not going to be on our terms, because it's much bigger than us. If there is a new story, it is life's story. And it is being born because life is always being born.